everybody. Welcome back to my porch. You can't even see the porch right now because I have so much stuff up here. This is part of the contents of my horse trailer. I hope the volume is okay. I'm not sure about the microphone on this camera. But if not, I'll just do a voiceover afterwards. Anyway, I think I told you guys that I was getting back into riding and training for endurance riding again, camping with the horses and like that stuff. And a lot of you have told me how much you like seeing stuff about the horses. So the project I've been working on is getting my trailer inspected the bearings packed and the brakes tested and the breakaway system replaced, and I got it all done and I brought it back and it's parked out there. But before we go out there, I think this is gonna be 3 different videos, maybe 4. So if you like this kind of organizational sorting and cleaning stuff and then putting everything back in its place, I can show you the empty trailer and all the different storage things in there. And then the other side of the trailer has 2 compartments for all my camping gear. And most of that is still in there because they didn't need to access that side. But I need to take everything out, wipe it all down, and clean it. Same with all of this because it's been parked and all the stuff's been in the trailer and it's gone through dust storms and smoke from fires and everything else. Extremes of temperature. So I have lots of things to sort through. I have a bucket with some soapy rags in here that I need to put some water in so I can just wipe things down as I go. This big thing is a dog bed. Belongs in the back of my car, but I've got everything folded down there for maximum space to get that back over there. So even though it's an SUV, this takes up the whole back where she sits. So that there. Everything else is from the trailer, except for my stove back up there. And of course, the minute I sit down to start making a video, that neighbor came out. So I kind of postponed for a couple of hours. And now my other neighbor, the dad, is out riding a bike around on the property. And the dogs are barking. I'm pretty sure it's going to get quieter. But this is kind of a vloggy video, do you think? I think so. Alright, first I'm going to unveil all of this stuff so you can see what I'm up against. Brand new tarp that's clean. Oh, voila! This is part of it. All of this was in the trailer. These were actually in the storage shed. These are great slip-on sort of mud boots. I have to have something that goes on very easily, so these can just be slipped on. I need to clean them off. They have really good traction, but they're filthy. These I didn't get to use last year because we didn't really have a rainy, muddy season. It was just a ton of snow, so I had to put on the higher boots. But year-round, I always have these on the porch. These are the real muck boots. Muck boots. See that? Yeah. These are fantastic. They hold up to everything. And they're real stretchy, easy to put on, and you can just hose them off. Alright, where to start? Some of this stuff was like part of the camping gear too that had an overflow. So I have a backgammon board. I'm gonna get my fits in here. A little diagram on how to set the board up. There's all the pieces and the dice. Yeah, this thing has been to a lot of campgrounds. And it's been lost for years. So yay. I like to play backgammon. So that's been in a bag, so it's pretty clean, even though it's stained. It's well worn. And these items are for horse bathing, which I'm going to be probably doing pretty soon. A very nice kind of natural sponge that really soaks up a lot of water. And this one in a mesh bag with a short clip right here and a loop and a long clip. And this is for when I'm out on the trail doing endurance rides with the horses and you come across a water source, you throw this in. When you keep this in your hand, or you can put your finger through there even, and you swing it down into the water and swing it back up into your hand and just squeeze it down the back of the horse or down their chest, on their neck. You can kind of do it on the fly at a walk or a trot. I've seen real expert riders just like not even pause, just like swing it, flip it, psh, on there or go. So that's pretty cool. I haven't had this out for a long time. And then when you put it back on the saddle, they have extra clips like that, so you can clip up the loose part and then ride on. So you just release it, drop it in the water, pull it up, and then hook it back on the saddle. Most of the rides that I go to in Southern California, we don't have natural water sources, so they usually have big buckets set out, and they would prefer that you scoop water out of those and then use sponges, because they don't want to get the water all dirty, because all of the horses are also drinking from it. So I don't use this as often, but I'm glad that I found it. So here are some boots, different types for the horse's legs. These are shin boots that go around the inside of the horse's leg so that they don't hit their own legs as they're trotting along. It prevents them from hurting themselves. And I've never used these with my Arabian mare, but my gelding, who passed away, these were his boots, because he just had a funny way of going, but he was very comfortable to ride. So those will go in the trailer, just in case. I have a box of like a deep storage that I'll put those in. And these are for the back. It's like a bulb protection from clipping your heels, getting your heels clipped. I don't even know which horse I use these for, but we'll see if it ever comes up again. Right. Some toys. Do you want to play with these? Spaz like me, because I can't throw and I can't catch very well. Yeah, I can. I'm okay. It's not my thing. But I probably had these for the nephews at one point. Lots of stuff sacks. Always come in handy. An umbrella, which I won't open. Although, if it brings rain, maybe I should open it. This is my long lunge line. This can be tied to a halter on the horse. And it's very long. I think it's 3, 6, 9, 12, 15? Yeah, it's probably about 15 feet long. paper. I usually have all my ropes hung up. These are a few that go with solar showers to hang up in the back of the trailer. I turn it into a little cowboy bathroom back there with a big bucket, a big camping bucket, and then I hang the solar shower and stand in the bucket. Okay. I got another bottle of shampoo, hoping for a spa day before too long. I think I have some left, but this will last forever. Mane and tail. And this goes with the solar shower. Yeah, I have to put that back in the... I think I have that up in the medicine cabinet, which I'll show you inside the tack room. This is a tack box. It holds a lot of stuff. I have two of them. This is sort of the backup one. I keep things that I don't use often. This is a short length of thinner rope. This is called a come along. I don't ever whip my horses or do anything mean to them, but you can put this on the end of a very long stick called a carrot stick. You just loop it through there and push this through and it stays on the stick. So you can just swing it to get a little action out of them when they're in the corral or in the round pen when you're training. My horses are both so sensitive that I just raise my hand and say trot or canter. They go off. So, but this is a good training device. I have a poncho, an emergency poncho. A very special one from my friend Joy from New Zealand. And it says New Zealand. I haven't had to use it yet, but it's great to keep it in here. Always have something. I've got some rubber bands. Got some cling tape. Reusable and it clings to itself and it's a little stretchy. And a pair of gloves. I don't often wear gloves. My hands are so used to everything that I like to be able to feel where everything is, the reins. It could be a little slippery though. I did used to wear these. Got some holes worn in them. When it's really cold, I have warm gloves if I ride with gloves at all. What do you think? More sea otter. This may end up to be 4 or 5 videos at this rate. I have a lot to show you. But I have to do this anyway, so if this doesn't become a video, that's okay too. Because you guys are motivating me. Okay. So I have a few little pads you can stick inside your helmet. I have ultrasound jelly, aquasonic ultrasound gel, and that's for the heart rate monitors when I start doing endurance training. I'll show you all about that, but this is to make the contacts pick up the horse's heart rate, just like when you monitor heart rate at the doctor's office. And this is my heart rate monitor. I need to wash this entire thing. Look at how filthy. These go through endurance rides on the breast collar of the horse, so they're exposed to a lot of dirt and dust getting on and off. This is where it's all stored. So, Velcro. This is the actual monitor right there. It's upside down. There we go. Carbon fiber. cardio sport. And the little buttons on the back are where you plug in the leads. And there's two leads, two electrodes. And one goes up behind the horse's shoulder under the saddle pad. And the second one goes on the girth, just under, just below the ribs as it starts to curve under the belly. You put it right in there with the gel on these. And then I have a heart rate watch. Well, everybody has those now, right? These Fitbit things. They probably have them for horses too, but back when I was doing these endurance rides 10 years ago, this was like state-of-the-art cool. And I still love it. So it works very well. So that stays here. And then I have two different girths. Neither of which is the right size at the moment for Z, so I have a brand new one. And I'm going to show you, I have saddles back here, but I also have my whole setup, the saddle, bridle, girth, breast collar, and a few other things in my bathroom, the guest bathroom, because it was the least of what I could bear if somebody came and stole all my stuff off my porch, because I just didn't have a chance to all this away yet, so. But anyway, everything was still here. And this is new. I just got it. It's a detangler. So I'll be mixing that with some water and put it in a spray bottle so when I give them their shampooing, then they can detangle their hair. And this, if you've seen my horse spa video where I gave the horses a bath, this is the handle attachment with the holes for the water for spraying and for scraping the horse's sweat off as you're washing them. So I'll be using that again. That's called a wash wand. A wash wand. Okay. So that's in pretty good shape. Everything's fairly clean in here because I do use the tack boxes quite a bit. Where's the second one? The second one is back here. Okay. Get that one. Ready for all this? If you can see it. Got a horse blanket over it. Wow. So I have one, two, three saddles lined up. I have two big camping boxes, a kitchen stuff mostly, and some fire starting stuff on the bottom. And then I have horse bath stuff up here, and a lot of lead ropes and other ropes, and the two big buckets that I take for water for each of the portable corrals for the horses when I take them camping. I just feed them on the ground, but I give them water each, a huge bucket, like that. And then we got blankets like crazy over here, saddle pads, blankets, and grain. All of this for two horses. So, yeah, I've accumulated a lot of crystals and a lot of horse gear. Hopefully I can get rid of some of it, either pass it on or just get rid of it, but here we are. So here's another box. I always have some type of boo-boo spray. It usually has frankincense, copaiba, lavender, and melaleuca tea tree oil. And here's one kind of a hoof pick with a brush. This is a really cheap version scraper here. So I have recently replaced that. I haven't taken it out yet. And combs and brushes and a scoop for their grain. And a rough brush. Look at all that dirt. Oh goodness. These all have to be soaked cleaned. And then the soft face brush. Soft, 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 super soft, super dirty. Everything's so dirty. And a little bit of some soft fleece. This is a noseband cover with Velcro. You just wrap it around the noseband at the bridle. Make it soft for the horses. Squeak, squeak, squeak. And another brush. This is a smaller one that I just got because it has a good grip. So you can really... And a hairbrush. Z, another comb, and a rubber curry brush that you use in a circular, especially in the summertime when their coat is very short. It gets all the dander up, and it's good for the saddle pads too. Get all the salt and sweat off of them when they dry. What else? That's about it. These two will go back into the trailer last because they'll be up front near the door. These are all blankets, I think, but they need to be laundered or given away, or both. Laundered and given away. For each horse. That one actually fits Z perfectly. But it's losing its waterproof. I've redone it a few times, but I may replace that one for her. And last year, I replaced Reyna's blanket. And she proceeded to somehow rub on anything that would tear the side open. And so, I've made it into... A gorilla tape work of art now. Gorilla tape is my best friend. So, I don't know. In a couple of days of downpour, this would not be working out, but we don't get all that much rain here in Southern California in the desert, so I'm gonna see if I can stretch this out through the winter, but I may replace this one as well. Horses are rough. She likes her blanket. They both do. Look, here's another rip. Just found. I spent so much time sewing this by hand and then enforcing it. Anyway. It's not easy loving horses. And these I definitely have to find homes for. This one is a big, heavy canvas blanket. Canvas and leather, like an old tent. I keep thinking it's such great material for something. I have a hard time to give stuff away that may be useful. I don't think it would be good to put on a horse. It's so heavy. But I did use it for a long time. So, this may go in a bag in the shed because I still think this canvas is going to come in handy, but I don't want the weight of this in the trailer anymore. That's going this side. And then I have these beautiful, soft, polar fleece blankets for the horses. This one is a nice dark blue, violet, or burgundy, maroon. But they're very hairy and they need to be laundered. And these are great because if the horse is a little sweaty and it's chilly out and you put this on, it wicks the moisture, the wetness away from the horse so they can cool off and dry. And then there'll be like a layer of moisture on top of the blanket. And sometimes I layer it under their other waterproof blanket just so that they don't get too sweaty and it allows the water to move through. I have the one that was covering all of those saddles. That's the other one. So I have two of those. This one is probably only useful during endurance rides. This is a rump rug. Yeah, a butt warmer for the horses. Put this on under the back of the saddle. It has straps that will attach to D-rings on the side. And this can be rolled up. It has weights in the corners over here, so it stays down over the horse's butt with his tail coming out right here. And it just keeps the big hindquarter muscles warm while you're ready to start doing an endurance ride where you're going to be riding all day. And some running, some trotting, and some very sometimes rugged terrain. So you want to warm them up slowly. And mostly we warm our horses up before we even start riding, or as we're just beginning to ride while we're waiting for the start of the ride. But on some occasions, if it continues to be nasty or if it's raining, you just want to keep those muscles warm. And then, as it warms up during the day, you just roll this up. Go around to hold it closed. So you just go out and like that. And then there's one on this side as well. And it just stays up behind the saddle, just nicely rolled up and out of the way. It's great. I have some old saddle pads that I don't use anymore. That's going to be a giveaway for sure. Somebody who needs these little, they're not little, they're wonderful. They're screens for the windows. But I don't think I really need them on my trailer because I have bars and I just put their fly masks on so they can see through the bars. They can't stick their face out. And they've got the mesh against their skin anyway, so I don't really, I haven't found a use for this. I think I won it in a ride. It's brand new. But I think I only got one. So maybe a giveaway or something. And then this one, the same thing. This is a corner feeder. It's a mesh on the bottom, so liquid just goes through. And you can put hay or grain in there, and it sits in the corner of a trailer. But I have built-in mangers in mine, so I don't need a feeder. And this is a really nice one. I won this. It's called Hold Your Horses. Yeah. Sometimes you get these nifty little prizes just for competing or for finishing top 10 or all kinds of different ways. They give out prizes. They give a prize to the last person to get in. They give a prize to sometimes the oldest horse, or all kinds of different things. So, and then I have a citronella candle. I have zero fingernails. They're still trying to heal. Cut them all off several times. This is great to have at the picnic table and light it up. It smells great. Keeps away the mosquitoes. A few dead moths in there, unfortunately. But always keep that in here. And it has a handle on it that keeps coming off, so emergency sneakers that I always keep in the trailer, and it would probably have to be a real emergency. The bottoms are pretty slick and they have been very, very well worn, but you never know. So just in a pinch, I do have something to put on my feet. This is for the dogs. If we go off grid somewhere, which I don't have have a lot of water, I could always use this, or it can also be used for washing dishes. It cools down to nothing. So it's pretty good for backpacking. But I do have a little one for the dogs for when I go hiking. So I'll keep this in the horse corral, put it in the tack box. And have this little one for my tent. Or for just around the camp where we're sitting. Yeah, the dogs' beds. This can all fold up into itself in this pouch right here. That's a zipper right there. But I like to leave it hanging because it's an oilskin. It's an Aussie oilskin poncho. There's the hood. Riding, it can cover the front of the saddle, behind you, and even the back of the horse a little bit. It has a zip-up pouch in the front. It has snaps, so you could have ventilation, or you could close it up. And it says here, Kakadu Traders from Australia. Can you see that? A long time ago, and it is very waterproof, and it's great because when you put your arms out through here, but the sides are stitched so you don't get rain down inside there. Great. It smells like camping. Fantastic. Very warm too. Unfortunately, when it's raining here, we don't often get it really cold, but that is a must have. And to go with it, now these are not oilskin, these are nylon, but they're waterproof. They're called, they're from a company called Muddy Creek Rain Gear. They are individual pant legs. So this is the bottom. It has a little rubber or elasticized strap here that your foot goes in. So it holds it down over your shoes. And you can even just put it on. I'll show you. Just like that while you're riding, one leg at a time. Because you already have your poncho on. And then this part at the top goes around your belt. It's a Velcro. And then it attaches on the side. So it keeps your legs up. And I have one for each side, obviously. And sometimes if it's not raining too badly, I can get away with a windbreaker, short little rain jacket, and just put the legs on over my pants, because if it only rains for an hour, you don't need to have a whole bunch of gear on. That's it. Got some trash bags. And another whisk brush. And another umbrella. I wish it would rain already, because I'm ready. So, I think I can get this out of the way. For laundry. Somebody asked why I have such a huge front load washer and dryer, because I live alone. But the thing is, I want to be able to do bedspreads. I don't use it very often, and I can do small loads and hardly use any water. But when you have to do stuff like this, I don't want to go to the laundromat, so it's a lot easier. Now, I'm going to move this up. Maybe I'm going to move the camera over there. And so you can see better. Hold on. Here we go. Let's try this. How's that? Now you can see a little bit more of the view from last time on my stones. I have the rest of them on that side. So, this I have to take back out today for sure. Horse's grain. They've been whinnying for it every time I go out there. Okay. So here I have three saddles. So these are going to go in the back of my vehicle. Back on the saddle rack out there. And I'll show that to you probably in the next video. So this is the other polar fleece blanket. Filthy. Absolutely unbelievably filthy. I'm gonna be sneezing later. On the next video, I'll dress nicer. I've got spots and stains and dirt all over me. Sorry, guys. Okay. These have to be gone through. This is picnic stuff. If you've seen any of my camping videos, you know I'm into the checkered tablecloth. I have some of these little net umbrellas that you put over your plates of food or your food items to keep the bees and the flies out. It has a little string that you pull. The flies off you. Oh, that was great. And then I have a million other things. Pots of pan. A colander. Coffee mugs. This one still has coffee. Last thing I did before I left camp, I guess. And rice, coffee. Oh, that's good to know. This is really an emergency box. A headlamp. I think I have a headlamp in every box of my camping gear and horse gear. So I can always find a light if I need it. Oh, this is something I've been looking for. I wasn't sure where I put it. This is a expandable tube that you can use to blow on a fire. From a distance, so you don't. So I'm going to put it in the little bag that I showed in my last video from the Nomadics, I guess it's called, the Nomadics monthly boxes, with my fire starter and my little forky thing so I can make things over the fire. Yeah. I like this one because it has different settings, but it also has the red light. And when I'm camping with the horses, it doesn't hurt them. Well, Once I get this all set up again and go camping, I will give you a camping box tour if you're interested. They even have slid down in here. An old time star wheel. Yeah. You can look at the constellations in the night sky. And now we have apps, so we don't need that. I still like them. I don't know what all else is in here, but I think a lot of the things will need to be discarded. Oh, I have some of these extendable forks for roasty toasty marshmallows. Okay, I think that's everything. Here we have some jerry cans, because I bring a lot of water. I have a 30 gallon tank on board, and then I have the 7, and let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, I think 5 gallons, and then another portable 5 gallons for drinking water. So lots of water for dogs and horses and people. And that's it. All of this is going to be organized, cleaned. Then it'll be loaded back into my car and brought out to the empty horse trailer, which I'm going to take the time to wipe down while it's empty in the tack room area. And then maybe I'll do a little empty trailer tour. Would you like to see my horse trailer? Things like this are like my favorites. I love little doodads and things that are well planned out and thoughtful. So my horse trailer is like my favorite piece of gear outside of having a roof over my head. Having a truck and trailer completes it. And I have a place for camping gear and for riding gear. It's just wonderful. So I'd be happy to show that to you step by step as I put everything back together in there, and hopefully get out really soon and take you camping with me. Alright, so it's really hot. My face is probably red, and the sun's coming down right here. Got a couple more hours of sunlight, but at least the air is feeling fresh, and once in a while the chimes go, and the birds are happy. So, yeah, step one of many to come. But now you see all the things that I had to get out of the trailer before I took it over for the servicing, and now I want to see if I can put half of it back. I may even keep the extra saddles. I'll keep the western one and the one that I'm currently using in the trailer, and the other two maybe I'll set aside some storage. I have so much organizing to do. Yeah. But it's going to be good. A fresh start. Let me know if you like this kind of hanging out with me while I organize my life kind of videos, and then I'll do a few more in the series when I get to the camping gear and the empty trailer finally, and then as I put things back. So what do you think? I'm grateful. I'm looking forward. I'm going to enjoy the things that I have. I'm not going to think about all the things that are gone and all the things that were missed, because only right now matters. Right now it's all good. And you're here. Perfect. It's all the motivation I need at the moment. So thank you very much. And now my other neighbors are chitty-chattering, so that's my cue to say goodbye. Thanks so much for being here.